And we're back at the lake house for round two. We gotta get these cars unloaded. And then I suppose we'll get to work because this isn't a vacation home yet. It's more of like a work home. I'll show you guys where we left off. Or wait, you probably already know. But let's go in there. I gotta unload this stuff first. Got a lot of goodies to go in. And then it's work time.
Everything looks like it's there where I left it.
So we got a little bit of the hallway done. I had to get the right tools to put this flooring together. I didn't have them. We were trying to make do. And what ends up happening is you end up just breaking the lips off this flooring when you're trying to hammer them together. It's not good. So I got the right tool that flaps over that you can tap with a hammer. And I didn't have the right hammer anyway. So that's good. We held off on that. Also got the right saw so we can cut all the trim into place. Paint looks good. Everything's holding up pretty well. I want to talk about one thing though. So I understand a lot of people were not happy about the ceiling decision. I know it's not in right now, and the reason we went to this, it was just a number of circumstances and our ability to do a ceiling. But to avoid seeing every seam on the ceiling, because there would have had to been some serious drywall work done in here to get it smooth enough that paint would cover and be good, this was something that we could do. We knew we could do. I think you guys are gonna be surprised when we get the flooring done and the furniture in here and the light fixtures up and everything. You're not gonna be looking at the ceiling. You're gonna be looking at everything else. It's gonna look beautiful. Second thing I wanna talk about is the washer and dryer. There's a reason why we're putting it downstairs. I made a mistake by saying the basement. It's not really the basement, it's just the downstairs. This house is split 50-50. There's three rooms upstairs, three rooms downstairs. So regardless of what floor you put the washer and dryer on, you're gonna have to walk up and down the stairs. So it's kind of like a wash, unless only a couple people are staying here and they're only upstairs. So that's why we chose to put them downstairs, because there's way more room downstairs to have those than there is upstairs. It only makes sense. So in my defense, that's why. Because if you have all six bedrooms full, laundry is going upstairs and downstairs regardless of where the washer and dryer are. Okay, now that that's out of the way, let's go to work. While we're gearing up to do the flooring, there's two holes in this floor that I'm patching. The first one we did was last time we were here over here. It was a vent that they used to kind of pull heat between the upstairs and downstairs. Had an electric fan. Taking that out, we won't need it. The other one is, this is an intake for the furnace vent here. We're taking that ductwork out from the ceiling underneath, and I'll show you guys why in the future. But we don't need this here anymore. I gotta patch that up. So I just got done screwing some 2x4s on the sides. So that way when I put some plywood down to fill that gap up, it's got a supporting edge so when you step on it doesn't collapse in. Get that patched up, and then as we finish kind of organizing and getting this place ready, I think we'll start going to town on that flooring and see how far we get. Oh, I hate when you don't have enough lumber to do what you need to do. I had to use scraps, bits and pieces, but it's together, it's strong, there's a billion screws in that thing, it's not going anywhere. When the flooring's laid over top, it'll be fine. I got a little gap, I'm still gonna fill it up. You go back to the hardware store and a lumber yard and get some more stock, because we used up just about everything we got. Fortunately, there's not much more fabricating we have to do. Is it fabricating? Is that the technical term? What's the term for working with wood? Yeah, there's a term for wood. I am spacing it. Tell me, guys, down there. I'm gonna regret telling you to do that, but that's okay. I like reading your guys' comments. So here's a couple tools we didn't have last time we were doing that. And this is the Stomp Borer Agronomic Tapping Block. That's what that's called. It's got a little lip, so when you put it under the flooring, you can tap the side of it with a hammer like this. Didn't bring that last time. And then this tool, it vibrates, pretty cool. Vibration actually will cut into wood with it. I'll use this for all around the trim on the doorways. We gotta put a piece of flooring up to it, mark it, and then I'll use that to cut off the bottom of the trim so that way we can slip the flooring underneath it. We're ready to do this, let's go. We've had a couple chip on the edges. We're gonna put those aside as the spare pile that we're gonna use for the little things. I'm sure we'll have plenty of places to put them. Try not to chip them, but every now and then you chip an edge. We're getting into the parts that are gonna be a little tricky. Now we've gotta do the corners around the door frames and figure out how to make that angle and everything. It's not terrible, it's just, it's gonna take more time now. There is one more tool you can get. It's like those kids' toys with all the nails. And you can put your hand in there and it shows like your hand on the other side and nails sticking out. I don't have one, so we're just gonna use a square. Carpenter square, razor blade, and leg arms. And we'll get it to work. And because we don't know exactly what we're gonna do in the bathroom yet, that's still to be determined, we're gonna run the flooring into the bathroom and just leave it. And then if we decide to do something different in the floor in the bathroom, which I think we will, we'll cut it off, put a strip there, for the joint into the new floor. Same with these, because we're keeping the wood floors in these two bedrooms, as well as the tile, which is in this room as well. So that's something we haven't gotten yet, because I don't have those strips. Be similar to what's right here, which separates the tiling from the flooring right here. And then when we get this hallway done, we can do the fun part, and that's gonna be transitioning into the big room. I guess I could call it the great room. I know, it's not that big compared to, like, you know, some of these places. But it's big for us, and it's gonna be awesome. And wait till you see how we furnish it. It's gonna look beautiful. But we'll get into here, and we'll see how far we get a chunk of this done, probably call it a day, and go to day two. And tomorrow, my dad, my mom are coming with the pickup and the trailer. And they've got furniture, a new washer and dryer, all bunch of goodies that's gonna come to this place so we can start furnishing some of this. We've got this almost done. What we're gonna wait on though is the little strip that's gotta go on this wall here will actually be taken from the strip we got ripped this wall over here. So we're gonna hold off on doing all the edges just because we wanna get the majority of the bulk of the floor done. Cause we're gonna have scrap here and there in pieces, and we'll come back then and decide how we're gonna do the edges around this hallway. We also have these two closets to do as well too, so we gotta go work our way in those. But this is the cool part. This room has got this awesome LED daylight lighting going on in here, and it's bright and it's gonna make that floor pop. So let's get going. Let's bring the floor out here, get this great room done. Now that we're entering into the great room, this is a little bit tricky because the way it's worked out with the flooring, we're gonna have a scrap or strip waste, we're gonna call it, along this whole wall. And then it'll go back into full pieces as it enters into the kitchen. So it'll go all the way to this wall over here, but then we have to put them in backwards to that wall over there, which is not as easy as going forward with them. You're really supposed to start on the farthest left wall. Reason we didn't start on the farthest left wall, because this little piece of trim here was actually mortared into that tile. So we couldn't take that off, and we had to get the flooring underneath that lip. Well, there was no way, if we started over on the kitchen side, worked our way this way, then went back to the hallway, that we could have got under that lip and locked it in. It just would have been near impossible. So we decided to start with that lip right there, which will just make it a little difficult going into the kitchen, but I think it's gonna be easier that way than trying to get that in. That's why we're at where we're at right now. But it's got the table saw ready. We're gonna start ripping pieces to go along this wall, and then it's gonna be, hopefully go fast. Feels like it's been forever, and we're like barely a third of the way done with this room. It's like farming. What are you doing?
Painting. Lots of painting.
That's why we brought the ladies, because we hate painting. Haven't figured out what we're gonna do about the floor trim yet. I might try to reuse the stuff that was already there. I took it all off carefully, tried to save as much as I could. Some of it was brittle, but I have a feeling probably gonna have to buy some new trim for some of this. And we're having a little bit of issues with the floor kind of wanting to lift up in a couple spots here. Could be that's tight on the ends. We've been trying to keep a quarter inch around all of it, but I don't know, we'll figure it out. It's getting tired, it's getting late, wrists hurt, knees hurt, but we're about halfway done with this room. We're close, we'll keep going. See our pile of boxes from the flooring. He's been tossing down the stairs so we can throw them in the fireplace. Let's go to the garage and see what's going on in there. Leg Arm's wife, Sarah, is sanding everything. This is all the kitchen cabinets, kitchen hardware. It's all gotta get sanded because it's all gonna get painted. She's doing a good job. And second thought, we're tired. I think we're gonna shut down tonight, get some sleep. She's gonna keep painting because she's a machine, but no, we'll pick this up in the morning and get this finished, and then probably maybe go into the kitchen, and there's a lot to do. Stay tuned tomorrow. Good morning, everybody. We're back. It was a very stressful night. The kids decided that it was a great time to get sick. The first day in the lake house restoration, back at it. So it's okay, we're getting through it. I'm getting geared up. It's noisy in here. This guy over here playing with the table saw. But it is sure nice being able to walk around this corner here and go around the kitchen. I'm excited about that. That's pretty awesome. Flooring didn't get any further than where we left it off, but we're gonna start that, finish this out, and maybe go into the kitchen. couple decisions to make because we got to figure out after this what the next steps are. Right now, what he's doing is he's patching the holes where the washer and dryer originally sat right here to put them downstairs where there's three other bedrooms down there. So we got to get this moved up. And then mom and dad are on their way here. Got a trailer full of goodies and then we'll get to town on this place. While we were going here, I happened to look over and this lip, the reason why we started here, the flooring has pulled out. As we were working in here, this whole thing shifted it over. And we're like, oh no, how do we get it to go back? So he's got a pry bar and he's got the edge here. He's prying on it while I am jumping and skidding with my feet to try to kick it over. And it's working. It's just slow, but it's working.
You're supposed to leave a quarter inch gap all the way around the whole flooring between the walls. And that's what we did on that side. And here, but what happened is now the whole flooring shifted over and it was just enough to get underneath that. So when we move this back, I'm gonna put a wedge here that will stop it from moving and shifting. I know that's not what you're supposed to do, but I don't want it to come out from there later on in the future. When we get it shifted over, wedge it so that it can't shift back.
Ready? That is awesome. That took a while. Snap together vinyl flooring is literally the best thing that ever came to flooring. But it does take time and we made a couple mistakes here and there. But overall, I think we're only doing this once every like 15 years. Did a pretty good job. Gotta cut out the furnace ducts. Haven't done that yet. We're gonna wait on this final pass here because my folks showed up with a trailer full of goodies to come inside here. So we're gonna clean this up, bring them in here because it's a good place to put them in. And then we'll come in and finish that trim on the floor. I think I have enough flooring to do the kitchen too. I got a stack here, got a couple extra ones laying around, then a couple stacks in the garage. So we'll see how close my figuring was with how much square footage. Little bit of an issue here when we butted that up and got it tight, but I think we got it corrected for the most part. Just a little teeny gap. We can't get tight on this piece right here. That's okay. I might fill it with something, but it's so minimal. I mean, I can barely get my fingernail in it, so it's good. And we've got a pile of light fixtures to go in all over. I bought a ton of them, free returns. So we'll just mix and match and try and see what we think fits. And then the stuff we don't like, we'll send home back to where it came from. Let's go get the goodies and bring them in. Here's what we got, guys. A little dirty, need wiped down. It was a little bit of a drive to get it here, but a bunch of furniture. They're gonna look really nice inside there. Let's get these things inside. These are nice. But we're not done yet. There's another big piece that's coming in this room. And we gotta go get it right now. Gotta go pick up another piece for this place. This one's gonna be nice. This is gonna tie a lot of what we're thinking together. Let's go get it. All right, let's go take a look.
Hey Nick, this table's used. Did you know it's used?
Uh-uh.
I'm using it.
Oh, it's okay. I'm not actually that upset about that, but. Eight chairs, 122 inches when extended, like almost 4 feet wide. It's gonna be nice, okay. Well, we gotta get a couple things lined up before we can get this in there. So it's gonna sit in the back of this for a bit. And then we'll get it in there. Let's go. Just finished up the last little bit. Leg arm's got the flooring cut around the floor ducts. So that's good. I wiped the couches down. They look a lot better. I think we're gonna probably start after we finish up the little bit along the wall, head into the kitchen and do all the flooring in there. There's Dad. He's working on the plumbing. He's got a, gonna try to get the washer and dryer set up so we can start using that because with sick kids in the house, we need to wash stuff. And then in this room, Mom is painting.
Hi.
And I don't know where the wife went, but she was here. And then in this box, something special. Okay, I'll help this guy out. Don't worry, guys. I am working. I just have to stop and pick the camera up. Spent a lot of time shopping, and we got a whole pile of light fixtures. I just got done putting this one together. This is going over the dining table. My wife likes these. I guess we call them farmhouse style lights. So we've got a number of them that are matching on and off, but we want to get that table in here, but I would prefer to get the light up, the fixture up, before the table's in. That way I don't want to keep scooting around messing with it or climbing on the table. So I'll try to wire this up there, get it together. I got my dad's heading to the store. He's gonna pick up some light bulbs. We'll get it in there, and then hopefully we'll have some awesome light in this dim area in this house. What do you think? Got light bulbs coming. That's just a test bulb, but awesome. Now to the table underneath. I did see one issue. This frame is narrower than the fixture cup, whatever you call it up there. So I might have to do some mudding around that. Not a big deal, but it's secure. It's done properly above, and we'll get some lights in that. I think we'll get some Edison bulbs. I'm not sure exactly if that's the term, 40 watt. And with dimmer switch. Now that that's done, I'm gonna help Scotty here. Leg arms. We're gonna.
How dare you address me by my original name?
He's really my brother, if you guys don't know. He got turned into leg arms by you guys and me. But we're gonna go ahead and just run this flooring into the kitchen and just try to get this done while we're at it. It's just, flooring's just so slow. But look at this room. Look at it. Yeah, it's pretty sweet. And these couches, they're nice and clean now. I wiped them down. There's gonna be a TV in that corner right there, as well as one downstairs. And wait till you see that table when it's in here. Perfect. You know, one of the worst parts about doing filming inside this house is because all my cameras have magnets on them. There's nothing metal in here besides like the refrigerator and the fireplace. Guess what? New camera holder. Look at that. Time lapsing. I'm okay with this light fixture. It's exactly what I wanted. Fixture, table. This is a 9-foot table by almost 4 feet wide. It has the leaves extended. We've got 8 chairs, but we're gonna get 2 benches too. So we should be able to get that 10 to 12 people on this baby. Those are from Helena, Montana. The other couch is downstairs from Great Falls, Montana. These are, this was actually just 13 minutes away on their side of the mountain. So yeah, good deal on all this stuff. All used, but good condition and definitely looks nice. I can't wait to eat on this thing. Check out the furniture and the table. It's coming together slowly. I actually had a TV that I was gonna mount on the wall last night, and I opened the box up and the TV smashed. Shipping came that way. So I gotta send it back, get another one. But that's okay, under warranty. They'll take care of that. But this room's awesome. The guys are working hard over here. I'm gonna start jumping in and helping him as too. He's patching up the old holes from the old washer and dryer. That's all there, so he's mudding and taping it and everything. And Dad's getting his coffee in.
I'm doing my part. I'm taking care of this redo.
Yeah, redoing that cup again. And then I'm gonna jump in here, and I'm gonna break the flooring up, this tile. If it was the same level as the rest of the floor, I'd probably just floor over the top of it with that snap together vinyl flooring. But because it's got a ridge, it's gotta come out. This bathroom's gonna get redone anyways. So we'll put the new flooring in. I know normally you'd probably do the bathroom then do the flooring, but it's not gonna be that hard to work around with that flooring in here, and this way we'll be in and out, so. But that's the plan, so let's get to work. Got sweat running down my eye protection. Whew, that was messy. With the bathroom all tile free, there was a crack all around the edge where you could see water whenever this area flooded. It was starting to show signs of rotting some of the wood around. So I filled some silicone. I ran a bead all around the corners here so So that way, hopefully, if it ever floods again, it'll contain it in this area and you'll be able to mop it up instead of going down the cracks that you won't be able to mop up. While I've been doing that, Leg Arms has been really good about getting this flooring done. He's got all this wrapped up, getting right up against the old tile over here. But the problem is, had to make a transition because that tile is raised or elevated so much higher than the floor level that he's actually putting spacers in here to basically make kind of like a ramp that'll lift up to the tile. And then we have a strip that goes over that. And Dad has been working on drywall on the inside of the closet. And I just went through and installed felt pads on every one of these 8 chairs, as well as large ones on the table. Because not everybody's gonna be conscious about scratching the floor. And yes, this floor is pretty durable, but it still can scratch. Everything can scratch. So they've got felt on them now. We'll see how long that holds up. I gotta do that to these as well. I want everything that's on the floor to have fairly new felt pads on them, just as a level of insurance. I don't feel like I'm getting much done though. So let's keep going. And in this room, Mother is doing something I hate. He's a master painter. So she's doing a good job. This room's getting a nice neutral color in it. So we were just talking about how that helps with matching stuff. This one's gonna get some paint, but I think we're gonna leave this wall as well as the trim and everything the same color. And then we gotta transition this flooring into that flooring. It doesn't look the prettiest together, but it's better than nothing. So well, we're winding down. Kitchen, flooring's just about pretty much done. Bathroom, didn't get to it. We have just enough flooring to probably finish this place. Really close. But we've got a mess in here. I'm just kind of tearing through these light fixtures that we ordered, assembling them, holding them up, seeing which one looks better, which one doesn't. We tried to find the best bang for the buck for the price on lights, and I think we got it figured out, but I need bulbs, and we might try to hang a couple of them tonight. We'll see. So we're still rolling. Well, we managed to work up enough energy to try to get the main fixture of the stairs up. It's a big one. They rigged up the ladder against the wall. Hopefully not gonna scratch. By the way, till tomorrow to get lights, because we don't have any to put in that thing. But tomorrow we'll get them, we'll put them in, and we'll try it out. But for now, we just get a look at how cool it is. Welcome back to the Lake House renovation. Things are happening, good things. Dad's still in the closet, and we've got this fixture here, it's up. That fixture's up, just gotta get some bulbs. Leg Arms is making a run, town to get that. I'm gonna install a fixture here and the fixture here. That way we can get some hallway light in this dark hallway that's been this way ever since we took down the original lights. So let's get to it, we'll put these lights up. Let's see if I did that correctly. Bulb in, on, ha ha ha. I don't know if that's enough light or not. Might have to get a bigger bulb. Or a higher wattage, I say. Whether the daylight would work better in the hallway, I'm kind of wondering that. We'll figure it out. Got options. Just finished the bathroom. We're gonna put the molding around the edges, so that'll hold that down. Different toilets going in. This is a wall mount. We're getting a floor mount. They're a lot cheaper. We just have to redo the plumbing. We got a couple closets we're just finishing up on. Got a bunch of scraps on the table right here. We're trying to pick through. A lot of them are the wrong side. That's just how it turns out, so that's fine. I'm just finishing cutting a couple pieces here. So I got some fixtures lined up that we gotta put together. And then here's the closets. So Dad's working on this one a little bit. I'm just finishing up this one. One more piece to go in, that one's done. A couple in here. We've got enough flooring to do it. And then there's one strip right here that connects into that bedroom. I think then we're done with flooring. That's gonna be really nice. And update. Guys, the floor is done. We finished it. Every closet's finished. Ended up being exactly one sheet extra from what I had picked out when we did it. We threw two extra boxes in just to be on a safe side of things, and turned out we used them. But I got one more box just as a backup. I'll keep that in storage. You never know when this floor goes out of production and something melts part of it, or who knows what happens. So we'll have extras. We got lights looking good. Haven't done much in the kitchen, but that's okay because we're working around here. The transition to the floor, really nice. This guy is up, looking good. That big one over there, 6 bulb, 4 bulb, looking really good. We are on a budget, so we're trying to stick to that budget. And that means light fixtures we can't spend a tremendous amount of money on. They can go anywhere from like $50 to like $1,500. So we're trying to keep the light fixture costs down So we've been picking models that are just on the cheaper end, but still look good. These look pretty good. This room, originally these fixtures were not supposed to go in these rooms. It's a temporary thing. We're probably gonna change that out for something different. It's just, I had ordered a bunch of different things for the hallways. We decided we didn't want that in the hallways, and we're like, oh, these rooms don't have fixtures in them. They're gonna be dark. So for the time being, we just put those in there. They were cheap. That's gonna get changed out. We'll get something better. But that's just temporary. It's just enough to give light to the winter when we're working around. This room is like 99% done, painted. The door needs painted, but all the trim's done, all the walls are done. Just gotta change out all the outlet covers, all the switches. Actually, Dad changed that one. Awesome. And back here, working in the hallway. They're working on that. And I am actually just starting to take this handrail off, which we painted on, but I'm gonna sand it down. I got stain for it, some dark walnut, and then I've got some polyurethane, I think is what it's called, sealer for it. So, staircase transition from the flooring to the carpet's done. I probably could have done a better job, but I don't really have a good way to cut that stuff. That's the only problem. So, I'm gonna keep taking this off, then sand it down and stain it. And then I got new brackets to hang this handrail on because this one was broke when we got the place. Now that I awkwardly put that in there for everybody to walk around and not bump, because they won't, I'm sure. It's gonna cure, and then I'll come back and seal it. It's not far off from the same color that it originally was, but it had a lot of dings, scratches, as well as paint from us earlier. So it's okay, get a fresh new coat of some dark walnut on there, then I'll seal it, and then I got new brackets, put it back on the wall, and we'll have a nice handrail back here again, because it is nice to have a handrail there. That's actually a pretty nice board. All right, it's the next day. It's been really slow, but we've been getting things done. These are just the slow, slow things. Check this out. This hood and this countertop range here were like a beige color, which worked great at the time, but not good now. They didn't even match the rest of the appliances here, like black, 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 black. Well, as you can see now, they're black. I tried something. This is made for like barbecues and appliances. Supposedly it's a really tough finish that can go on here for $6. I painted it. We'll see if it holds up. I'm sure scrubbing on this might get rid of it, but you know what? $6 worth a shot, you never know. If it doesn't, then it's like $750 to replace the hood and the countertop range. So I figure $6 is a good gamble if I gotta get rid of these. And this one should actually last because, well, you hardly scrub on that. This one, I don't know. But they're both very functional. They work great. Switches are awesome. Fan is fast. These heat up nice and hot and quick. I hope it lasts. We'll find out. Another thing that's been going on is changing out all of the light switches and wall outlets. So, that's nice. I bought a little bit higher quality switches. They feel nice. The ones in this house, some of them were so worn that literally when you flicked them on, gravity would turn them off. They were that bad, which is not good to have that weak of a connection inside of a switch. So, all new switches, all new wall outlets. Got the covers on the face plates. They're all nice and white. It used to be a mix of black, beige, and white in this house. Now they're all white, which goes well in this room. Slowly cleaning up our mess. We got couches that are kind of scattered around. Boxes of fixtures and all kinds of stuff scattered around. Tools scattered around. It's coming together. This kitchen, as you can see, we brought a lot of our food and stuff that we've been living downstairs with. Upstairs now, we're taking all the cupboards home as far as the doors and the drawers. And we're gonna do them at home, prime them, paint them, get them prepped, bring them back and install them here. Reason we're doing that is there's not a heated garage here, and two, we're running out of time. We're gonna be heading home soon, and we have time at home, so we'll carefully paint them, prep them, do everything we need to do, load them up in boxes carefully, bring them back here, and then install them with new hardware. We stuck with the copper backsplash. It actually is genuine copper. It's real copper plates. So we're keeping that. We're gonna have some really beautiful copper fixtures that hang down here, as well as copper hardware throughout the kitchen. That should look nice. It's just kind of different. I'm liking this. This is good. Things are going slow, but fast, in a way. This week has been something else. It's very stressful coming here because we're trying to get as much done as we possibly can in the limited time we're here. And we also have a bunch of munchkins running around downstairs. And here's what happened. We came and 2 days in the middle of the night, one of my kids started throwing up repeatedly throughout the whole night. So I spent the whole night taking care of that kid, and then the whole day working, and then the next night, the next one got sick. And so dealing with that one. And then, here's even more. My mom's birthday is today, and she's sick. She hasn't been sick in ages. She's usually pretty good about that. But we're getting it done. I'm not complaining, because here's the thing. I recently got to listen to Marcus Luttrell don't know if you guys have ever heard his story, but he's a Navy SEAL. And when you hear what people like that have been through in their lives, you realize I have it so good. And if I'm holding a little kid over a bucket while they're throwing up, not getting sleep throughout the night while I know I gotta work the next day, and a lot of stress and pressure and everything that's going on in life, I have to remember, life is great and I've got it pretty good, and it's just a season. And guess what? One day I'll come here with a key, open the door up, come inside, start the fireplace, sit down and enjoy the view, and it's gonna be amazing. So life's great. Then remember that. Remember, everything's blessed. I just, the fact that I'm in this place doing this is a blessing that a lot of people haven't been able to do. So I have nothing to complain about. But I'll tell you what, it's making for good memories. This place is already building character in our lives. We're just about done with our time here. We're gonna head back home, and then hopefully after the holidays, we'll come back and start round three. So, all right guys, thanks for watching. God bless, and Merry Christmas. Take care.